Yes, remember Red Bar in the Wild. If you could get us in the wild, get another podcast to talk about us, get somebody to tweet about us, a cool comment thread, you could receive $100.
It's like a pawn shop.
Yes. Yeah. Pawn shop rules. I might take a look at it and go, sorry, kid, this is not worth my time. But I could also look at it and give you that $100, which many people have obtained. It's not a gag just because I didn't give that guy $100. You know, they're going to start with the rumors now, the remarks. He's actually not paying people for the Red Bar in the Wild. I am. That'll be the last I'll ever hear of that, which I haven't heard of any. Just so you know. This first Red Bar in the Wild comes from, let's see what we got here today. I'm still waiting for them to pop up. Or maybe I could do this. Here we go. Red Bar in the Wild. Who do we have? Okay, let's start light. We love this guy. This guy's been great.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, these are so fun. We'll start light here. Okay, this comes from Facebook. Thank you to Brian Rad. You could lower that wild there because I'm going to pipe up Joey here. He's on to Mike's burner accounts is what this one's called. And we're going to hear from Joe Matarese. You guys remember Joe Matarese? Briefly, Joe Matarese was a comedian in New York City, an older comedian. He was on America's Got Talent, right? He was on Howard Stern.
Oh, I miss him a lot, to be honest. He was getting butterflies thinking about him.
He had a big, hopeful career. He was on pace to be one of the regular touring comedians of the world. He was on pace to be like a, who's the bread maker? Tom Papa. You know, he could have been a Tom Papa type guy all over town, just being a professional comedian. Nothing too exciting, but he could have done the rounds. Well, he was on Compound Media. He was on Anthony Cumia's show when Red Bar was on Compound Media. Long story, very short. We made fun of Joe Matarese. Joe Matarese and his wife called Cumia and reported us. They did something called... They told on us. They tell. I saw someone making fun of Trevor, one of the interns from Good Mythical Morning, Rhett and Link's intern Trevor. Do not make fun of Trevor. He tells. You don't want him telling on you. Okay, so you got to watch out for guys who tell. Joe Matarese got his start on Red Bar because he told. Him and his wife went to Cumia and says, there's a guy making fun of me on your network. What's this about? This must end. Cancel culture. Yep. Tried to cancel me. Well, we had our fun with Joe Matarese. Documentaries were made. Joe Matarese turned into kind of an underground sensation for a while, being made fun of by various communities.
Do you think he kind of misses that too? His heyday?
I think he misses his heyday of being like the number one fool. He was like the Brendan Schaub of a very smaller community, group of people, but he was kind of like, he had a Brendan Schaub couple years where he was the guy everyone made fun of. They made documentaries about him. We've
one
gone
time
back and forth.
He made a pizza that went from day to night.
Yep.
That was one of my
there's been so
moments.
Much. Type in Joe Matarese in our, he used to be one of our top guys. So here he is. And since then, I consider myself friends with Joe Matarese. You know, here's how you know a good fool turns into a guy that is no longer mad at you. That's the goal. You want to brutalize somebody so bad and put them through so much like Joe Matarese that the only option left is to really like me as him. And I feel like that's where we're at. I could be completely wrong. I could be remembering other stuff. But I feel like if you ask Joe Matarese, what do you think of Mike?
I think he's great. I think he's a funny guy. I mean, he's doing well for himself and, you know, the king of these types of shows. And I wish him luck.
That's what I think. I don't know. But I consider myself a friend.
That seems like the natural course that
right?
you usually take.
That's what usually happens. So let's see where Joe Matarese, you could pipe that down a little bit more and then
love you.
See what this is.
You're taking Red Bar's look. Yes. Does he just go by the name Red Bar, that guy?
Mike? You mentioned. Red Bar in the Wild.
Mike Redbar. You guys are good, man. Whoever you are that back Mike Redbar and the way that you go on to everybody's live streams and mention his shit, I give it to you. That's fucking genius.
Yes, so Redbar in the Wild is working and people are even picking up on
this. Genius, they're saying.
Everywhere you go, you're hearing comedians of all ages, all over the globe. Everywhere you go, you just see Redbar, 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 Redbar. How annoying would that be? And then it's me, this shitty guy, and they can do nothing about it. That's the worst part. So, yeah, I guess that's what's happening here. We're on Instagram Live. People in the comments are Redbar, 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 and he's had enough.
Mike Redbar. You guys are good, man. Whoever you are that back Mike Redbar and the way that you go on to everybody's live streams and mention his shit, I give it to you. That's fucking genius. It's great. I don't even know it.
And that, by the way, is just a consolation prize. We're only doing this for the thrills. You know, we're only doing this for the tapes. These tapes make everybody very, very happy. And, you know, if it turns into promotion, that's great. I don't think any, if you're a fan of him, you're not seeing
this. I just
like
this because I love Redbar.
Yeah, if you love Redbar, Redbar in the Wild is an amazing thrill because you don't really see Redbar out much. You don't know if it even exists, really, or if it's just something you and your wife know about.
Mentioning Redbar in the Wild could get you in big trouble, maybe. It's a risk.
Yeah, it's very risky. So, yes, it seems like he's sick of this shit. It's when they start saying it's genius, that means they want me dead. That means they're so sick of this shit.
Way that you go on to everybody's live streams and mention his shit, I give it to you. That's fucking genius. It's great. I don't even know. It could be him with different accounts. Even if it's that, that's still good. It's good for you, man. You're doing it right. You guys that are on my stream right now, the eight of you.
Imagine me at home.
Can we? I feel so bad for him. Can we hire two guys like Leo Dominique or someone who has a lot of time to just maybe for a couple of weeks you go, Joe Matarese is watching.
Joe Matarese watching. Get us some new Matarese stuff. Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm saying he's like, oh, I'm so jealous of Mike. Right. Yeah. He's watching. It's so great. A nice thing to do for him is once in a while he can be like, hey,
Joe Matarese is watching.
Check out Joe Matarese.
Yeah, that'll be helpful for his career. Joe Matarese is watching. What? Joe Matarese? That guy from the East Coast? What's his problem with me? Because I know a lot about him. Here's a story about him. Where
you should switch for like a week to only saying Joe Matarese is watching to everybody and cause a lot of confusion.
Yes, Joe Matarese is sending out. He's got an audience, a legion of trolls.
Tell people, go in their comments and say Joe Matarese is so pissed. He's flipping out.
Yes, do all the old gags, but with Joe Matarese to see what happens.
You never know.
You never know. And always say, I heard Joe Matarese is doing this.
Yes.
You can't say for a fact. That's defamation and slander. You don't want to be caught up in a fool's trial where they try to get you legally. Isn't that the worst? They love discovery. So watch out. Here we go. Let's see the rest of this tape. Joe Matarese, Redbar in the Wild. Nice to see
you. Guys that are on my stream right now, the eight of you. Ooh. Start going on everybody's live stream and just mention Joe Matarese.
Do it.
Just do that for me. Because this guy's fans, who he's mentioning right here, that's what they do. They'll go on everybody's live stream and they mention him in hopes that you'll go watch his
podcast. That's not why. Can you imagine? Yeah, they're all doing this in hopes that they bring more people to watch.
We don't want them here.
You think they're doing this because they want a larger group of friends to watch the show with? No. They're doing it because it's...
Everyone is saying pick.
Because look, everyone is saying what?
Sorry for interrupting.
No, go ahead.
Everyone is saying pick a fool to say that to. Just go to anyone who would know Joe Matarese.
Spread it evenly across the U.S.
Like, Joe Matarese is going crazy right now.
Anyone that might know him. Anyone that might know him.
Exactly.
Yeah. He's trying to find you. Yeah. We heard he's trying to find you. You know, because that's not me. They could say that about me. I'm giving them permission. But, you know, Joe isn't.
But he kind of gave it. He said, go do what you're doing.
He did say that. So, yeah, I take it back. This is his instruction, not us. Okay.
Or, you know, follow his stuff. So do that the same for me, everybody. Start mentioning Joe Matarise on everybody's live streams. Write it on.
And you want it done the same way Red Bar does it. That's what you're implying.
I mean,
Your Honor, inflammation.
Yes. You know what? Let's end this. You win.
You know, I didn't realize he was going to ask for that. That's incredible. I don't know if I caught all that.
Their Instagrams, like if they post a video, just fucking start throwing my name all over the place. Could you do that for me? That's my goal with this. Create
copy and Red Bar on the web.
Like, it's almost like they own me, like I'm a racehorse. Just do that. Even if it's for a week, I'd really appreciate it.
Start oh, my God.
All right?
Dollar signs.
It usually comes up in a negative way, even though I'm...
Wow.
I don't think I'm a dick.
Oh, my gosh.
Stop worrying.
So you haven't learned a thing. I thought you were nice now, and, like, this was all behind you. You're getting all worked up again. You're back to your old immaturity. You're a father of three kids.
And aren't the kids like 18?
You have a house like from a show that we watch. Every show we watch that we're talking about, the houses look like Joe Matarise's house. Where there's so much sun. The neighbors are all amazing people that you could have over. He lives a life like that, and he's sitting here yelling at the screen.
He would actually fucking kill as the main character of that type of show.
Of that type of show. That could be
a lighthearted 30-minuter.
Yes, a lighthearted 30-minuter, 800 ads.
Oh, he would be good.
Oh, if you guys get Peacock Premium, it's $5.98 a month. It's their highest level of service. You'll watch a show, and you'll just interrupt it by a 60-second, twice-as-loud ad in the middle of the scene. That's what they do now in shows. And they don't even like have it timed out for the break. It's just like a YouTube ad where it just pops in. That's crazy, man. That's fucking nuts. How long are we going to put up with this? How about instead of the writer's strike, we strike the studios, huh? We should go on strike from watching, huh? Help them. Okay, here, let's see the rest of the tape. It's longer than I thought.
Instead of, you know, it usually comes up in a negative way. Even though I don't think I'm a dick, but
you're acting
for some reasons.
Ooh, he's getting mafioso. Ooh, you're getting East Coast. You're acting East Coast.
All right, so go do that. You've been busting ass, and you deserve it. Yes, dude. More than 30 years in the biz.
Wow.
So go mention me on some other live streams. All right. You guys have a great, great week. And tell everybody you know that Joe Matarise is going to be at the Stress Factory in New Brunswick this week.
And that'll work.
Go to his website to buy tickets, and then you'll have access to his after party.
Eight viewers. You get to play this has, by the way. Pong. Seven viewers.
You know? What's better than that?
Seven people who are joking to be there, by the way. Isn't that nuts? Some man... Father of three, East Coast man living in that house with a wife, is on there talking to seven fakers. This is a kid in a school bus. Yikes.
Oh, no.
Get that out of there. But isn't that interesting? That's nice. Joe Matarise, good to hear from you. So that guy gets $100. That's worth $100. That tape, whoever posted that, okay? Hit me up. Give me that Venmo.
That's a good one.
That is a good one.
See? Good tapes, good prizes.
Oh, this one is so good. I love this one coming up next here. I had no idea this guy knew me. This is a big honor. Because this guy's more famous than Kill Tony himself. A regular on Kill Tony. Might be graduated right now. It's an honor. David Lucas, everybody. David Lucas, come on down. The next contestant on Red Bar in the Wild. This is David Lucas with my friend... Proud to say that, by the way. Alex Stein. Now, if Alex Stein wants to keep this friendship with me, he will disavow Steel Toe. And again, I'd love to have a relationship with Alex Stein. When I see him, I light up. He makes me light up. Do you understand?
Yeah.
David Lucas and Alex Stein talking about me. I can't wait to see it. Here it is. Thanks to Scott Loveless. It's been around for long enough to definitely earn that 100, because I've been going around saying this new slogan. Light mentions. Let's hear what they say. This is going to be your new favorite catchphrase here.
I'm naming it.
Oh, let me blow you up. Let me blow you up. Oh.
Uncancelable.
Oh, I like that. Okay. Okay, now, guys, now I'm going to put old David Lucas on the spot. You guys ready for this, Jimmy? You didn't even know this. David Lucas's dad is Trick Daddy's manager. Is that true, David? The one of the greatest rappers of all time, Trick Daddy? Isn't that, no. What is that? Is that a fake rumor? That's a Red Bar rumor?
That's a Red Bar rumor.
That's a Red Bar rumor.
Our Red Bar rumor. That's a new term out there.
Tappin' Skins, can you make a song that's like that's a Red Bar beat, rumor. And then at the end of the hook,
that's
it's
a
like,
Red, that's Bar, a Red rumor. Bar rumor. That's a Red Bar rumor. A Red Bar rumor is something so good.
And did we even, did we
it's
start?
It's bigger than a rumor. It's like, I heard a rumor. A Red Bar rumor. That means a big, that's a doozy. Did we start that? A Red Bar rumor? Now, I don't know what they're talking about. I'll say this. I don't do rumors. I do predictions, visions, premonitions, futurizing and such like that.
I started a few rumors.
No. I'm not a rumor guy. I really don't like when people use that against me. It's like when Josh Denny goes, all he does is lie about me. That's not really what the show is at all.
By the way, I want the song to have a thing where, like, a guy says one thing, like, a guy's like, that's a Red Bar rumor.
Yeah. That's a Red Bar rumor.
And it repeats.
Yeah. And it's line after line.
Yes.
Trick Daddy, my grandpa, that's a Red Bar rumor.
Now, that doesn't really seem like the kind of rumor we would spread.
That's not the type of rumor. I don't remember saying that.
If I have a memory.
I did mention Trick Daddy earlier today.
About how David Lucas was rich or something. So maybe I like read that comment in the chat or something.
So let's hear this again. What is this Trick Daddy stuff?
I'm naming it uncancelable.
Oh, I like that. Okay. Okay. Now, guys, now I'm going to
that's funny.
I'm
going to
put old David Lucas on the spot. You guys ready for this, Jimmy? You didn't even know this. David Lucas's dad is Trick Daddy's manager. Is that true, David? The one of the greatest rappers of all time, Trick Daddy? Isn't that what is that? Is that a fake rumor? That's a Red Bar rumor.
That's a Red Bar rumor.
Why did you do such a big sigh?
That's a Red Bar rumor. You know Red Bar. That's where you know you're getting $100 when Red Bar in the Wild. That's one of the things at the end. You know Red Bar? And you all say that with me at the same time.
It's nice.
So that's the point of this segment here. We can't believe these people know us. We think of these as characters from TV. You know, we're watching YouTube the same way we're watching Platonic. Through the same system. Alex They're all the Stein. Same stars to me. And I see them more than George Clooney.
So true.
I only got one screen there that I look at. They're all on it. They're all equals. So David Lucas knowing about me, that's like if, who is one of the, you know, Wesley Snipes knew about me. So this is the same. That's a Red Bar rumor. That's a Red Bar rumor. Nah, that's a Red Bar rumor. It is? You know, what's a Red Bar rumor? Or is that a rumor that I spread? Or is a Red Bar rumor just a term for a rumor that's not true?
Because we're so full of shit.
Yeah. Okay, well, there it is. David Lucas and Alex Stein. Nice to see those guys. I can't believe they even know each other. You know, that's...
Alex Stein should replace Tucker.
Alex Stein should replace Tucker. I mean, he's a better person than Tucker. That's for sure.
100%.
A lot nicer. A lot more human. That Tucker, guys, do not... Trust me on this Tucker thing. I don't want to get into it. This is not politically inspired. Stay away from that Tucker, please. You're going to make a fool of yourself.
Alex Stein, I'm not going to write you in the Red Bar in the Wild show note every week.
It can't be every week, Alex Stein.
But I still love you.
Exactly. And guys, stop trying to get Alex Stein has mentioned us. He's been wilding. Well, wilding out and Red Bar in the Wild.
Oh.
And wilded. Alex Stein, yeah, he's done. You don't got to keep doing it to the same four guys over and over again. Let's get a little bit more creative, okay? Stars, big names, okay? Not these guys. You could do one more Alex Stein, I'll allow.